dear Thomas, distinguished guests, it's a pleasure, obviously, for me to be invited to say a few words to investors and people who reflect about the political and economic future of this country. I am very impressed, obviously, by the long list of speakers. I guess that this list of speakers reflect the standing of dragon capital in this country. It's true that anybody who wants to know what is going on here has to read your political and economic analysis. So thanks very much once again for inviting me. It's not easy to be original when we speak about investment in Ukraine because almost every day we are asked the same question. How is it possible that a country which has all the assets that Ukraine has does not manage to attract investment? And as we all know, attracting investment is extremely important because without investment, you don't have economic growth. And without economic growth, we can forget about job creation. In 2016, we saw a slow but steady economic growth in Ukraine for the first time over the last 3 years. And this is very much welcome, obviously. And according to most economic experts, this trend will be consolidated in 2017. But a growth between 2.5 and 3% in 2017 is not obviously as impressive as it could be. We know that the economic recovery remains extremely fragile. And many of the challenges that this country is facing are far from being solved. First of all, this country is a victim of a foreign aggression, and we know that there is no solution of the Donbass conflict in sight. And we know as well what the political and economic cost of this conflict represent for Ukraine. We know as well that the trade and economic relation with Russia has been, over the last few months, further eroded. This as well has a huge economic impact on the economy of Ukraine. And the external environment remains extremely challenging, to say the least. But, we all know as well that the biggest challenges for Ukraine stem from domestic factors. And insist on that, nobody should take pretext of the conflict, which is a real problem, to forget about the main reason why we don't manage to get more foreign investment in Ukraine, and these reasons are mainly domestic. 3 years ago, we know that thanks to the new political leadership, Ukraine embarked on a road of complete political and economic transformation that should bring this country closer to the EU, which should as well modernize the political scene and should reorganize the economic structures of the country. We hope, obviously, that this reform, which are real and which are totally unprecedented, I dare stating almost every week that more has been done in terms of reforms over the last 3 years than in the previous 23 years of independence. But we know that obviously every time the new political leadership tries to impose a reform, we have a number of vested interests who struggle to try and derail the reform process in the most important sector. And to make matters worse, in addition to this domestic opposition to reform that anybody can easily understand, there has been this illegal annexation of Crimea and this foreign aggression in Donbass. And all this obviously added to the obstructive trade policies carried out by Russia, who has been historically the biggest economic partner of Ukraine, has rendered the reform process even more difficult. I should add to this obstacle the fact that, as we all know, it is always very difficult for the political leadership to get the new legislation through the Rada. We know that in the Rada, a number of vested interests, the so-called oligarchs, are able to manipulate a number of members of the parliament. And this, obviously, is a major obstacle to any serious and deep reform in the main sectors of the economy. I have to accept, obviously, the fact that populism is not a monopoly of Ukraine. We have this kind of difficulty in most parliaments, in most countries, even in our Western world. Ukraine is not at all an island where there would be corruption, pollution, and all these terrible things, while you would have other countries which would be exempted of all these weaknesses and diseases. We have exactly the same challenges, but it's true that Ukraine has an history which makes it a bit more difficult to face most of these challenges. Alors, there has been obviously criticism about the slow pace of reform and the hesitation that we have witnessed sometime from the government. And these criticisms very often are justified. But at the same time, again, nobody can contest the fact that in key sectors for the political and economic life of these countries, tremendous efforts have been made to improve things. Look at the situation of the rule of law, the reform which have been undertaken to fight corruption, to get an independent judicial system, to modernize the public administration, to promote decentralization, to reform the gas market, to improve the situation, which was a total disaster in the health sector, to reform some important segments of the financial services sector. All these reforms are real and are a good basis to resume economic growth in the country very soon. It's clear that in some sectors we have been a bit frustrated. And it's clear that when it comes to the restructuring of state-owned enterprises, when it comes to privatization, when it comes to land reform, we were expecting a bit more. We have understood the main obstacle to the reform in these sectors. The government is fully aware of what has to be done. Let's hope that they will have the political will to take the decisive measures to promote the reform in this sectors. Despite these real reforms, we have all seen that investors have been hesitating to come back. And to be extremely abrupt, the level of foreign direct investment remain extremely slow. And all this despite the many assets existing in this country that I want to name once again. First of all, the well-educated workforce. I am really surprised every day in Ukraine to see the level of political awareness, of education, of sensitivity to IT technologies of a large part of the population, mainly the youth, obviously, people who are below 40. There is no need, obviously, to elaborate on the quality of the agricultural land. Ukraine is a big country of 45 million inhabitants at the heart, in the center of the European continent. You have low cost, you have a long industrial heritage, and despite all this, and I'm sure that I forget a number of assets, you don't manage to get investors back. And the answer to that is very short. There is no need for me to be long. Rule of law, rule of law. The lack of rule of law in this country, despite the reform which have been undertaken, remains the main reason why companies, investors, continue to tell us, with the current circumstances, we hesitate to go back to Ukraine. So, what does this mean? This means that the reform in the judicial sector has to move ahead. First of all, a large number of judges have to be removed, and new judges selected on the basis of their competence have to be put in place. This is something absolutely essential if Ukraine wants to reassure potential investors. New anti-corruption courts have to be put in place. We are every week, one way or another, explaining the government that there will not be rule of law in this country as long as we have the old judges in place and as long as we don't have new anti-corruption courts. We want as well to make sure that the new judges will be selected by panels composed of independent experts. And the international community is ready to assist in this regard. In addition to all this, obviously, we have to make sure that the new institutions which have been put in place will see their prerogatives respected and will get the necessary means to carry out their task. And I say this in these days where many people are a bit concerned, and we are concerned, about the situation of the National Anti-Corruption Bureau, NABU. We know that an audit is about to be carried out, and we really hope that this audit will have as a main objective to identify weaknesses which will allow us to improve the efficiency of NABU and not to get rid of the current NABU leadership, who has been doing a remarkable job up to now. So all these reforms have to be put in place, have to be continued. It would be necessary as well to have a real reform of the public prosecutor office. And in this regard, up to now, we have not seen the positive sign that we were all expecting. We would like to see a new Supreme Court in place as soon as possible, as well as a High Council of Justice. On all these tasks, we have mobilized a lot of means. We, the international community, the IFIs, a number of donors, and the EU, obviously, because under our association agreement, we have taken the commitment, the Ukrainians and the Europeans, to align the Ukrainian legislations in all these areas on the EU one. And therefore, we are ready to share our experience so that you don't repeat our mistakes. We are ready to make sure that what has been done in countries of Central Europe over the last 15 years by countries who are today members of the EU and who have been through this reform process with success, all this experience is today at your disposal. So, to sum up, there is one condition to attract investment in the future in this country. This is to continue the reforms which are necessary to impose, to establish the rule of law. Once there is a rule of law in Ukraine, you can be sure that all your neighbors will suffer a lot, because we are far many assets, far more assets than most of your neighbors, including in Western Europe. Thank you.